Come in.
Good, you're here. Listen, I want you to do me a favor and investigate a potential story. You see, I ran across this old photo in the archives, and it reminded me of a time when I was still a reporter. It was 1969, and my editor sent me to Linden Shades, an orphanage on a farm just outside the city. The orphanage was supposedly haunted. Authorities relocated the children and closed the orphanage, even though they concluded that the ghost stories were a bunch of nonsense. But they were wrong. I saw those children's drawings. They all had one thing in common: bloody red monsters. Those children were afraid. Heck, even I was afraid when I saw those drawings. The principal said she had proof that what the children saw was real. She said she had it on film. She wanted to show it to me, but then the phone rang. It was my editor. He sent me to cover a breaking story, and it ended up being the one that made my career. I left and never looked back. But I've never been able to shake the feeling that we missed something out there. The place is abandoned now. Head out there and see if you can dig up anything. Maybe you'll find the truth.
there, stranger. I'm Bob Walker. I own the farm next door, and I saw you going through that gate. Lots of folks poked around here in the past, but never found anything. They say that Linden Shades is haunted, but I don't believe in that, hooey. Someone at the window, you say? But nobody lives there now. It's abandoned. It must be your imagination. But better safe than sorry, I always say. That's why I don't let my son play around here anymore. I'd love to chat, but I've got a lot of work to do. So long. Thank you.
Happy birthday, Kim. Come on, everyone. Let's sing her happy birthday.
Calm down, please. It's going to be okay.
I can't sleep. I barely managed to calm the kids down. Kim's birthday was ruined. And the kids were right about that boogeyman. I saw it too. It was red, just like the ones the kids drew, standing just outside the window. I don't know what's going on, but some of the teachers are already packing and leaving in fear. After a long and sleepless night, I shook off my fear of ghosts. It had to be someone playing tricks on us, but why? I decided to call the police. The police were no help. They said they couldn't find any evidence. There was nothing they could do. Well, if the police want evidence, then I'll find it. Whoever's behind this better beware. You mess with my kids, and you mess with me.
Hey, it's you again. It happened in the stables. Then I saw it. Then it was gone.
Oh, hi. I don't have time to talk now. He's all right for a...
couldn't sleep one night. Standing at the window, I saw someone sneaking through the backyard. In the morning, I found footprints in the mud. The police weren't impressed with my night prowler story. They said the footprints could have been the groundskeeper's. I hung up, and then I thought to myself, what if the groundskeeper is terrorizing the kids? He had a bad temper, and he screamed at them once when they trampled his roses. I'll set my camera up tonight and catch the culprit on tape. That will give the police the evidence they need.
Thank you.
Last night, I took my camera and headed outside, ready to catch the prowler on tape. I saw the groundskeeper leave the house and head toward the stables. I confronted him about scaring the children. The poor old man broke down in tears. Oh, I was so wrong. It certainly wasn't him, and I felt terrible for accusing him. But I know there's something or someone still out there.
Guess what happened? I bet it's that ghost that's got everyone in an uproar. I guess if you really think I should call the cops, But if you catch him...
Today's our last day. They're closing Linden Shades. The children are so upset, and I can barely keep myself together. They found foster homes for all the kids. I hope the best for them, and I'll remember them always. They're very special to me. I'll stay here tonight to close the place down. I tried my best, but I failed. It's time for me to say goodbye to the kids now.
Last night while I was packing, I'm glad I thought to grab my camera as I finally caught the villain on tape. He was standing there, adjusting a red robe he wore. I couldn't see who he was. Then I had to hide, so he wouldn't see me. I thought the police would finally listen to me, but they dismissed me once again. All my effort for nothing. No one cares. I can't believe we've been undone by a man in a red robe. I hope he gets his. I'll never forget how happy we were before the terror began.
Yeah.
Well, you're putting our family business in jeopardy. Make yourself at home.
Whoa! Not Dad and Uncle Jack. I know it's not my fault. I did as you said.
You've done excellent work here. Not only are sales up for the paper, but you've also helped catch the crooks who've haunted this place for years. It's great to see the orphanage open again. The governor promised to use the income from the mine to fund education for the children of Linden Shades. I know you went into journalism to help people, not for the byline glory, but now you have both. You should be proud.
City News, can I help you?
Oh, good. You're the reporter who broke the orphanage story. I'm Amanda Sheldon, headmistress at Linden Shades. We need your help again, I'm afraid. The deed to the orphanage property is missing from our safe. The bank is making a claim of ownership, and we're in danger of losing the orphanage. The police are trying to track down the deed, but haven't found anything yet. Please help us.
I'll see what I can do. I'll be there soon.
Thank goodness.
Mrs. Sheldon, this...
But Mr. Jones...
Very well.
We need...
Boy, am I glad to see you. I think the deed might be in the manor. Go on and see for yourself.
Well, my supervisor won't be very happy.
Yes, it does. Now...
Linden Shades will always have an important place in my heart. Their joy is the biggest prize I could ever win. I couldn't ask for more. I hope to be back soon.